Welcome back on this Veterans Day. Currently, we have wind advisories out there for northern Houghton and Keweenaw counties, along with some of our eastern counties highlighted in the brown color. There's also a storm warning for Lake Superior, a gale warning for Lake Michigan. And we also have a lakeshore flood advisory in the green for parts of Delta and southern Schoolcraft County and into the Keweenaw. We're going to see some strong winds, and that'll pose a problem for us today. We are going to see wind gusts exceed 40 miles per hour in several locations. We'll have two rounds of rain. The first one is exiting the area and the next one is on the way. This is the area of low pressure. It's a strengthening storm system that's located right over parts of western Wisconsin. It is going to continue to lift north and northeast here over the next 24 to 48 hours. But right now you can see the rain showers with the first round tapering off across the eastern counties of the UP. And now the second round, we're starting to see some light rain work into parts of our western counties over in Gogebic and in parts of Onondaga counties. So right along M28, just west of Marinesco along US 2 through Ironwood and Wakefield, seeing some light rain at the moment. Current wind gusts out of the southeast with this system in excess of 30 miles per hour for most places, 44 mile per hour wind gusts over at Houghton, 32 over at Escanaba. Over at the Mackinac Bridge, you can see the flag kind of waving around in the wind with those gusty winds this morning. So as we continue, winds will still be out of the southeast, gusting near 50 miles per hour over into the Keweenaw and to the eastern counties. 40, 45 mile per hour wind gusts expected throughout the afternoon. And then by the evening, we'll start to see it taper off. This is 7 o'clock later on this evening. Biggest impacts, travel. Look out for some toppled items, a few lids, trash cans. Lids, maybe even some down branches or limbs of trees. You can potentially encounter some power outages. We could potentially have some scattered down trees and branches, some localized flooding along the shorelines of the Great Lakes with some larger waves that will develop here as the day progresses. This is the first round of rain that's now exiting the area. There's going to be a lull and a break from the rain for the bulk of the morning. Then here comes the second round throughout the afternoon. After one, this is about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, widespread rain as that center of low pressure lifts north. By tomorrow morning, just some light rain showers and a little bit of a mix. But as the cooler air filters in on the backside of that low, a transition to some snow across the western counties. And then by Saturday morning, lake effect snow showers ongoing along our north and northwest wind belts. We could see a few predominant bands of lake effect develop on Saturday evening and into Sunday as well. Mid to upper 40s this afternoon for the western counties, near 50 degrees in the central and in the eastern counties of the UP. Our temperatures will drop off into the 30s this weekend. Now, for rainfall amounts for today, basically right around half of an inch of rain expected with this. And then by Monday, we could see right around 4 to 6 inches of snow with some of the predominant